Kailey, thank you so much. It is 5:46. New for you this morning, a poor diet. It can impact our entire life. For some people, there's just no option. A lot of Arizona families are struggling right now when it comes to food insecurity. And as our Allison Rodriguez learns, the source of that problem lies in a lot of neighborhoods.
You've likely heard the term food deserts, but do you know about food swamps? These are communities or areas where fast food chains and convenience stores outnumber healthy food options.
I mean, either processed packaged foods or foods that are energy dense, lots of calories, lots of...
Dr. Poonam Orivachaspati is a researcher and professor at ASU's College of Health Solutions. She studies how community food environments impact families, specifically children. While still a relatively new term, she says food swamps highlight the lack of access to fresh, healthy foods in metro and rural communities.
In Arizona, for example, in metro areas, you have about maybe 13 to 30% of the population that has poor limited access to grocery stores or supermarkets. In rural areas, those numbers are 40 to 70%.
The COVID-19 pandemic making this even worse for Arizona families. According to a survey done by ASU researchers, nearly one in three households experienced food insecurity during the pandemic. Hispanic families, households with kids, and households with a job disruption were more likely to become newly food insecure. As a result, many were having to use credit, borrow money from loved ones, or rely on food banks for support.
If we're doing 30,000 pounds, you know, let's just say a pound of food is a serving, okay, to a meal. So that's about 30,000 meals a year that we're able to do.
Dave Smith is the director of the urban farm at St. Vincent de Paul. The half-acre farm, located in South Phoenix, just off of I-17, provides fresh fruits and veggies to the food bank so families in need can have access to them.
Well, if you're really going to optimize your health, I mean, every study says it over and over that good nutrition is just essential to having the energy to lead a decent life. So it just doesn't work with, you know, all the sugary, sweet, fast food that may be around and may be available, cheap calories, and so just doesn't work.
Smith says the urban farm grows all kinds of nutrient-rich foods, things like broccoli, cauliflower, kale, beets, and more. The entire farm is mostly run by volunteers from the Valley community.
It's our volunteers that carry the day to both plant, weed, cultivate, and harvest the food that goes into the kitchen.
From the food bank's kitchen into Valley homes, the urban farm becoming just one of the solutions to this much bigger problem. Dr. Orivachaspati says this is about more than meals. It's also about changing mindsets.
They all bring the community together to kind of start thinking about healthier eating. And then if we can use those, what is grown in these places to kind of bring it back to the community, that's fantastic.
Well, that was our Allison Rodriguez reporting. St. Vincent de Paul is providing grab-and-go meals from five dining rooms for those in need. And to volunteer with the urban farm, signing up is easy. Just go to the food bank's website.